the backbone of the church has been Black women almost from the very beginning, but their role has been suppressed.
Can you tell me a little bit about two women in particular that we thought we might focus on? Nannie Helen Burroughs, and a little bit more about Mahalia Jackson. One, Burroughs as a, you know, fighting for women's rights on the political side. And then Mahalia Jackson, of course, gospel singer supreme, but also got so involved in the civil rights movement.
Frankly, I didn't know much about Nannie Helen Burroughs until I read my colleague Evelyn Brooks Higginbotham's classic work, Righteous Discontent, about the role of women in the Baptist church. And Nannie Helen Burroughs in 1901 formed what's called the Women's Convention, which was the feminist wing within the Baptist church. When the Baptist church, when the National Baptist Convention was formed in 1895, it swept the country. A huge percentage of Black Christians joined the Baptist church. Today, there are various Baptist denominations under the larger Baptist rubric, but we'd say maybe 30% of Black Christians are Baptist. But Nannie Helen Burroughs organized women to do forms of social protest and social work, and remained an active voice in the civil rights movement until her death, I believe in the 1960s. With Mahalia Jackson, she was offered contracts to record secular Black music, and she refused to do that. And her alliance with Thomas Dorsey was a way for her to bring in forms of Black secular music into the church. And their alliance is what created what's called the golden age of gospel music. And one of the most moving stories to me is the fact that when Martin Luther King was experiencing despair, those long dark nights of the soul, that he would call Mahalia Jackson and he would wake her up and just ask her to sing. I'm gonna walk in Jerusalem, talk in Jerusalem, you know, one of her classic songs. I'm gonna walk in Jerusalem, talk in Jerusalem, singing Jerusalem. This would lift his spirit and let him awaken and strive for another day. That's amazing. And it was Mahalia Jackson who was sitting behind him on that historic day in August of 1963. And Martin is reading his prepared speech. And, you know, the audience is responding and everybody wanted the brother to do well. And Mahalia is behind him saying, tell him about the dream, Martin. Tell him about the dream.